Hello everybody, Justin DeLay from Reverb.com here, taking a closer look at how guitarists can use Ableton Live as a real-time looper and musical sketchpad. We've already taken the liberty of setting up the audio interface, getting the guitar amp mic'd up, so we're going to dive right in. If you want to learn more about how to set up an audio interface and configure Ableton Live for recording, take a look at a previous video. But now we're going to turn our attention to transforming Ableton Live into a really fun, really simple, real-time musical scratch pad. First things first, I'm going to open up the browser in Ableton Live by clicking on this little arrow here, and I'm just going to search for a rock drum loop, literally typed rock, and found a rock drum loop that's apparently 72 BPMs. I am going to click on this, drag it over into the first clip slot in my drum track. You can see it there. We can also view the audio waveform by double-clicking on that just to make sure that it's there. Then we hit play. And we've got a cool 72 BPM rock drum beat that we can then use as the foundation for further guitar jamming, looping, layering, and song building. This drum loop here is natively at 72 beats per minute. One of the coolest things about Ableton Live is that it treats tempo at the project level elastically, meaning you can stretch it, you can tighten it, you can push it, you can pull it, you can move it all around, you can take a slow thing, make it fast, take a fast thing, make it slow, and it always sounds awesome. So, for instance, again, we're at 72 BPM. Now I can tap the tempo in by literally tapping on the tap button, or I can click on the BPM that's up here in the top left corner of the screen. I can type in the BPM if you know exactly what you want. We'll go from 72, we'll pick it up a little bit, get it up into that sort of funky range, 95 BPMs, kind of got a good groove. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna play back the drum loop. My man Tibor is going to record a single note guitar riff. We're gonna knock it down an octave to make it into a pseudo bass line. We're gonna layer a funky rhythm guitar riff over top of that, and then we'll have a nice little loop so that Tibor can jam it out, play some lead guitar. Along the way, I'll show you a couple other little tips. Okay, let's get started. All right, our drum loop is playing. My man, whenever you're ready, hit me with something. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna listen for him to get back to the one, and I'm gonna use the session view of Ableton to record a loop. Here we go. So one of the cool things about the session view of Ableton is that the recording is actually quantized to the beat, which you can change. So it makes it super, super simple to start the loop on the one and finish it at the right point. Now, what we're hearing here is Tibor's original loop. I'm actually gonna kick up the gain a little bit so we can hear it, and then you can really hear the effect of processing it down in octave. So first things first, let's turn this up. Cool. Now, I'm gonna use the built-in transpose feature of Ableton on this audio clip that we just recorded to knock it down an octave. There's a couple different ways you can do this. You can treat it as a knob and turn it with the mouse, or what I like to do is you can actually type in directly on the keyboard the specific transposition you want to use, so you get a nice, clean, seamless change. So since we're recording all of the same input on the audio interface, I'm going to record enable the next track over. Yeah, that's cool. Okay, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna let him keep looping on that. when the one comes back around again, I have selected the first clip slot in this guitar rhythm track that I created, and all I have to do is hit enter, and again, it'll be quantized to the one. Here we go. Cool. So now we got that as well. I'm gonna turn up the gain a little bit again here on this clip, just make sure we can hear it real well. Now, just to show you how cool the Elastic audio of Ableton Live is, I'm going to actually speed up this whole loop that we've just made, and you'll hear that everything retains its pitch and retains its character. So let's speed this up a little bit. Sort of a 95 there, pretty cool. One last little tip, if you're doing this by yourself, if you don't have the luxury of having your good friend Tibor here, one little tip for Ableton that makes this really useful. You can assign key commands, literally pushing a key on the keyboard to do certain stuff in Ableton. You do that by pushing key up here in the top right, and you can then, for anything that's orange here, assign a key command to it. So for instance, here for this next clip that I'm gonna record of him playing guitar lead, I'm just gonna push the L key on the keyboard for lead. You can do the same thing, you could use R for rhythm and B for bass. And then if you're sitting here playing by yourself and you're jamming out, you know that you when you hit the B key, you're gonna be playing some bass, R is gonna play some rhythm, L is gonna play some lead. Today we took a close look at how we can use the Elastic audio in Ableton Live to jam across a wide range of tempos while keeping everything in sync and sounding great. We took a closer look at how to use the built-in looping in Ableton Live to create a musical sketchpad, something that's super fun for guitarists to do, make your own bass line, make your own riff, and then jam for hours. And ultimately, we made a funky little jam. So thanks for watching again, Justin DeLay from Reverb.com, and stay tuned for more.